Around the corner or around the world with the Greenup Beacon.
Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Education in Action with the GreenUpBeacon.com and our many, many guests today. This is the largest crowd we've ever had at one time. Are from Greenup County Schools. On the left is Gary Blevins, class of 2010 at Greenup County. Went to Moorhead, has a master's that he'll finish up in ag education.
Yep.
Yep. Is there no S on your machine over there? You got a P on yours? Was that hard on him?
Yeah.
All four of my kids don't say yep. Just say it. I guess you figured that out. And over here is another one who is Carrie Davis, daughter of Sonny Davis. She graduated from the University of Kentucky College of Agriculture, and she's got too many degrees to read, but she does have a rank one. And that's Carrie Davis and Gary Blevins. And I would like each of you to say your names, starting with the pretty side over here, and we'll come across.
Anna Jacob.
Pretty Benz.
Robbie Jones.
Keith Sparks.
Gary Atkins.
That's pretty good. They got that down. You all practiced that on the way up here? Did you get a blizzard?
Yeah.
Everybody got a blizzard? That's all that matters, because you know, Gary showed up with his blizzard, and I noticed that the host and the camera person got no blizzard. Cut him on out of the picture, would you? And so anyway, we'll take a break and be back in a minute. This is the OLBH Greenup Beacon Media Network at greenupbeacon.com.
Your heart, it needs special care. The cardiology team at Our Lady of Bellefonte Hospital specializes in chest pain, heart disease, irregular heartbeats, congestive heart failure, and more. From prevention, detection, and treatment, including cardiac catheterization, balloon angioplasty, and stent placement, our team is helping patients find the perfect rhythm. Visit bonsecur.com to learn more.
Betty Gallion and the Greenup County EMS want you to know the qualified staff is available to you 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. For transport, call 833-1515. And for medical emergencies, call 911. Greenup County EMS, when seconds count, accepting Medicaid, private insurance, and private pay. Greenup County EMS. Betty Gallion and the Greenup County EMS.
At First and People's Bank and Trust, we're not only your home office, we're your hometown bank. We're your friends, your neighbors, even your relatives. When you enter our front door, you're going to be our number one priority, because here at First and People's Bank, we're here to serve you. Tired of dealing with that corporate bank where you're just a number? Come see us at First and People's Bank and Trust, where we'll treat you just like a friend. Whether you're buying your first house, your second house, or financing a new car, come see us at First and People's Bank and Trust.
Thank you. And I think we're back, and we are. And so I'm sort of going to turn this over to Gary. And Gary, I have to look every time. I'll never remember your name because I want to. See, when I do sports, I have a roster with numbers. Nobody can see me looking all the time. So tell us about FFA and agriculture at Greenup County Schools. You figure out how you want to do it and take over. Use that rank one, girl.
We'll let Gary Atkins get started with some of the classes he's taken and some of the activities we've done, and we'll kind of just move down the road here. How's that sound?
So we started with a plant and land science class, and this year we take a horticulture class. So we mostly spend all of our time in the greenhouse or working on stuff that pertains to the greenhouse. So
we restored our old greenhouse, and then we are about finishing up our new greenhouse.
Okay, so before we move off that, you're not going to talk about the greenhouse, okay. Before we move off that, talk to me about what you grow. Do you grow year-round? I mean, do you do tobacco, whatever? Tell me what you do.
We mostly do stuff like people grow in their gardens, uh-huh. Peppers, tomatoes. We grow some flowers. We do hanging baskets, flowers that people plant in the gardens, so stuff like
you
that.
You sell those, don't
yeah,
you?
Yeah, we sell them for the
fundraiser. Uh-huh. Now, are you all FFA sponsors or advisors? So you help them sell these? Now, make sure that you send that to the Greenup Beacon, to my email, Hank at Greenup Beacon, and I'll help promote it for you.
That's how we'll sell them this year.
No charge, yeah. Now, when you're in the greenhouse, what do you do? Do you help dig and...
We start planting with seeds, and then we start watering them every day until they sprout. Then we put them into, like, transplants.
Uh-huh.
Put them into pots where they can grow bigger. And once they get big enough, like the peppers and vegetables and stuff, we can take them out, put them in the garden until they're ready to pick.
So how much land does your garden cover, Carrie? Do you know?
Oh, it's somewhere between a quarter acre, half acre.
I would say quarter acre. Pretty.
Now, the produce from there, do you sell it or is it given to the school? What do you do with it?
We've done different things with it over the years. We've donated some of it to Meals on Wheels and the Helping Hands. Youth Service Center has received some. We send some home with the kids. Some of it we take in the shop, and we taste test different produce that they may not otherwise get a chance to try. And then we have on occasion sold some pumpkins and other crops out of the garden. And then a lot of people have them buy and pick it too. So
sure, sure. Well, just, you know, I like tomatoes about this size. Just remember that part. Young man, you're up.
Well, I've taken about every agriculture class they have to offer, but two of my favorite has been the wildlife that Mr. Blevins has offered and the environmental science one. And in the environmental science one, we take like soil tests, and we find out like the pH of the soil and what we can do to better the soil. And we do water samples, and you can find out like your water quality. And in the wildlife area, you can learn about different animals that you might not be able to actually get out a chance to study, and then you get to learn about like the different trees and the forestry side is tied into the wildlife, but you get to learn about trees and what the trees do for our environment, and you can learn what this tree does versus what this tree does for you, and in the landowner prospect, what the tree has the benefit for you, like timber harvesting or for the wildlife prospect.
That's amazing. I don't think people that aren't in it realize how complex it is. Young lady?
So I have taken two of her classes. This year I'm taking vet science, and freshman year I believe I took animal science, which is basically learning the different species of animals and how they are in their own environments and how they deal with their certain things. And in vet science where you're learning how to like take care of the animals, how to bring out certain dosages of things and doing math with it to get the right amounts.
Well, I've taken a little bit of both of their classes, and FFA is involved like with the agriculture classes, because if you're in an agriculture class, you qualify to be in FFA, and then we go and compete at different competitions at Moorhead and ACTC, and we host some. And One contest is a speech contest, and so schools from around the region, we all go and compete, and we do impromptu speaking, and prepared speaking, and parliamentary procedure. And then there's also the, like, animal judging, and land judging, and plant judging, all that stuff.
Stuff. Do you all participate in the state fair? Do you go to the state fair as part of what you do, or?
Not as a club. We have a few kids that have shown their livestock, exhibited their livestock at the state fair and over the years. Our county fair is right up against that, and so some kids don't even take their livestock to the state fair because our county fair.
Yeah, I've never really understood why we have ours after the state fair, or while it's going on, one or the other. So we're going to take a break, and we're going to come back, and I've got a couple questions, and we'll be back in a minute on the OLBH, Greenup Beacon Media Network at greenupbeacon.com. Carmen Funeral Home for more than 100 years, the original mission of the firm hasn't changed. They've always intended to provide the best and most professional services complemented by the finest products. Carmen Funeral Home, people serving people since 1913, from pre-need to final arrangements. Carmen Funeral Home.
Before I got sick, I enjoyed retirement. This problem with my heart put a monkey wrench in the whole thing.
He is having severe, crushing chest pain. That's what people refer to as a widowmaker.
Kickstarters gave me my life back.
Our program consistently has received the highest rating for cardiac surgical care.
I've never seen nothing any better than Kickstarters. You gave me my life back. You gave me my future and gave me my family.
King's Daughters, online at kdmc.com.
And we're back with a rabid bunch of young people from FFA. I do have a question for you, and I can't remember your name, so you can call me again.
It's Brittany.
Rit Nanny, do you want to be a vet?
Parts ways, yes, but I mostly want to be a nurse right now.
A nurse?
Yeah, if that doesn't work out, I definitely want to be a vet.
It's, of course, you know, it's the same thing, but in two entirely different directions.
Yeah.
But I noticed that you'd taken a couple classes that were in that direction, and I just, the other four of you, and of course, you know, I don't remember your names, I don't have a roster, but... Are any of you planning to pursue a direct profession in agriculture? Not today.
Just the farming aspect of it.
Well, you want to farm, then yeah.
I take the classes to further my education in farming.
So I'm going to ask Gary and Carrie a few professional questions now. I don't see your daddy in your face. Agriculture isn't what it used to be. I mean, you have computers now, and talk a little bit about how technology, one of you, how technology interfaces with the world of agriculture today.
I'll take this one on, but there's been a lot of changes in the last, even just the last decade, but really over the last 30 years as far as technology, and it all comes down to a need to be able to produce more with less labor. You know, when it comes to agriculture, one of the biggest, most expensive inputs is labor. And so technology has really helped cut down on labor in certain areas, the need for manpower. And it's also been able to kind of help increase yield numbers. You know, when you have the values of certain crops, certain products aren't as high as you might once have been, the way you can supplement that is to be able to make more of it. as a farmer. So technology's been there, you know, to help push that, whether it be research and genetics with plants and animals, or even computers on the tractors and planters and different things.
The every business faces what agriculture faces, and that is you need higher yield at lower cost.
Right.
That's the same in the newspaper industry. They've gone through this metamorphosis of cutting people to maintain profits. And unfortunately, I feel like there comes a time probably in every industry where the end product suffers because you don't have enough people to. I know in the world of tobacco, when we lived down in central Kentucky where it was big time, can't get labor. People work till noon, get paid, not come back. You know, it's just, it's tough. So now do you also, and I mean, what is the difference between what you two teach? Why don't you tell me that?
Okay. So Mr. Blevins is actually on the tech center side. And so the Greenup County Area Technology Center is connected to the high school with that hallway. So a lot of our kids are easy to go back and forth. He offers the horticulture pathway and the environmental science pathways. And then on the high school side, which is where I'm located, is strictly the animal science pathway right now. So we both teach freshman level agri-science, so every kid can start there. And the agri-science class covers a variety of topics in agriculture, so they can then make that next decision if they want to go animals or if they want to head toward horticulture or environmental science. And there's classes tiered for them to take all the way through their senior year.
So you find it a challenge, do you?
I think it is challenging, but it's...
I don't mean that in a negative way whatsoever, but to answer the many questions I'm sure young people have about, because, I mean, just look what all these young people here have rolled out that they have done. And you have to sort of know a little bit about everything, right?
Right, or know where to go. And I think that's my main fallback is I don't know that, but I know some resources we can look into. And I'll be the first one to say... I've absolutely learned as much from these kids as I hope I've ever imparted to them. They all bring their own aspects of agriculture with them to the table. And sometimes it's real world experience, which all five of these guys have, but sometimes it's just questions. And then we all learn from those too, whether I knew the answer.
Right. Right. Yeah. So I'm going to go across now, before we take our last break and then you get to go get another lizard. What is your favorite part of this agriculture world, taking these classes, are the things that when you walk into school that you say, I get to do this?
My favorite is probably working in the greenhouse. I enjoy whether it's planting or transplanting or just seeing, you know, how everything turns out. I like to see a finished product.
I see it grow.
I like to start a seed and then see people buying it. You know? So if we start peppers, I like to see all the peppers grown and people leaving with them.
Mine's pretty much the same thing because my grandparents own a greenhouse, so I like
finding... With Hardens or...
Howard's.
Howard's.
Off a little road. And I like finding better ways to do stuff so I can go home and show them if they need another way or not.
I like being able to learn different things on stuff that I may not have known and being able to go home on my own farm and either try practicing that practice or just going out and seeing... like the different trees that I have growing and like what I can
Right.
use them for.
Do you have a garden?
No, sir.
At home?
No, sir.
Were you?
No.
No. Oh.
He's a cattleman.
Yeah.
Oh, you're a horse or a cow kind of guy, huh? Okay. Young lady?
So I like the aspect of that it's hands-on. So with the vet science class, we had recently had dogs come in and we'd give them exams. And I just think it's really nice that I get to be able to go home and try and make sure that, like, my dog would be okay and understand that, you know, I can do this if I don't need a vet to help me, that I can take their temperature and understand what's going on with them.
Now, when they bring in animals, does vet come in with them? You have vets interact?
Or? Oh, occasionally. This was just that the kids are really good about sharing their animals. So whether it's livestock or small animals, they're pretty much game to bring what they have in and share it with not just our high school ag classes, but there's an elementary school across the parking lot.
Right.
We have them over. So
that's great.
We have a good campus setup where we can have some hands-on activities with live animals.
Your turn.
Well, I enjoy having Mr. Blevins and Ms. Davis here to help all of us with anything, not just like agriculture or FFA stuff. Like, they're there for us whenever we need them, and it's just good to have people like that in your life.
Well, you guys get gold stars today. If you only knew the truth. We'll take one last break and be back with our little group here. This is the OLBH, Greenup Beacon Media Network at greenupbeacon.com.
Are you an adult looking for a new career? A high school senior ready for a new and exciting journey? No matter your education goals, we have a path to get you there. We have lots of programs to help you get a high-paying job quickly or work toward a bachelor's degree. Take advantage of the state's lowest tuition, outstanding training programs for jobs in your area, and online classes. Enroll now. Ashland Community and Technical College. Higher education begins here.
Welcome to Bellefont Animal Clinic. Dr. Amy Bess is a licensed veterinarian treating dogs, cats, and other small animals. Your pet's health and well-being are very important, and Dr. Bess and staff will take every step to give your pet the best possible care. Bellefont Animal Clinic is a full-service animal clinic and will take routine wellness cases as well as medical, surgical, and dental issues. Dr. Amy Bess, Bellefont Animal Clinic, 1500 Kenwood Drive, Russell. Call 606-836-9933.
Happy's Cookin' has breakfast all day, hand-patted burgers, and an all-you-can-eat soup and salad bar. Our friendly staff is here to make sure you have a great dining experience because we want our patrons to be treated like family. Happy's Cookin', 2135 Argolite Road, Suite L, Flatwoods. Call 606-836-3663.
Everything about Stultz Pharmacy is special because everything they do is aimed at pleasing you, their customer. Low-priced prescription medications, their unsurpassed selection of over-the-counter medications, drop-off and pick-up, drive-through window, free blood pressure screenings, free delivery, large selection of greeting cards, collectibles, Yankee candles, and gift items for all occasions. Just a few of the things that Stultz Pharmacy offers their customers every day. Stultz Pharmacy with locations in Greenup, Flatwoods, and Wheelersburg. More than you expect from a pharmacy.
Stultz Pharmacy.
Segment on education in action with our lovely and delightful seven guests today, of which I know Carrie Blevins, Mr. Yep, and Carrie Davis, Mrs. Yep, Ms. Yep. And before we go, I would like to compliment each of you on how well you have done today and tell you how much we appreciate you taking time out of your day, even though you've got a blizzard in the deal, to come up and explain a little bit about many things. I'm a city boy. I grew up in downtown Russell. So I, other than helping my in-laws house tobacco once, which I'll never do again, I don't know anything about agriculture. And it's amazing to me the things that you tell me that you all do and study. Yeah, I'm very impressed. So before we go, I know that is Gary Blevins, and your name is?
Anna. Brittany.
Robin.
Keith.
Gary.
You're Atkins. Yep. She called you Gary Atkins twice. I remember that. Keith, I don't remember your last name at all. Sorry. And Carrie Davis. Thank you all for joining us here today. Is there anything anybody wants to add at the end?
Thank you for having us on. We appreciate it.
Thank you for the opportunity.
We're really glad. I'm really glad you got to come. And, you know, just so you remember, guys, remind him that there's an S on the word, not a P. Okay? Thanks, guys. Thanks for joining us. Be with you again next week here on Education in Action on the OLBH, Greenup Beacon Media Network.
Around the corner or around the world with the Greenup Beacon. Around the corner.